Hey guys, it's me Larsa. Welcome to my channel. Where in the world am I today?
Welcome to Jaipur, also known as the Pink City. I spent 3 days in the city to experience my India Genius journey to discover Jaipur through fresh eyes with Agoda and experience the food, culture, and exploring the different parts of the city.
I am in the beautiful Pink City, Jaipur, here in Rajasthan, and I am so excited to explore this place. I've been to Jaipur once and Jodhpur thrice. I've been here like 4 times already. This is my 5th time in Rajasthan. I think that itself says how much I love Rajasthan as a state here in India. And I cannot wait to explore this. The last time I was in Jaipur, I couldn't really explore the city well. But this time, we're going to a lot of beautiful forts. We're going to have a lot of local food, yummy food. I love Rajasthani food. And I think you can sense the excitement in my voice already. And yeah, we are staying at this beautiful property called Fairmont Jaipur. I am going to be showing you what my suite looks like. This is actually a part of my suite. This is the terrace suite and it's so gorgeous. I'm going to take you through the grand welcome that they gave me, and they made me feel like a princess. And without further ado, let's get into this.
It started off from a very warm welcome at Fairmont Jaipur with Sonam, our personal butler, who greeted me with the beautiful Rajasthani feta and a silk dori bangle that denotes 3 things. To make the moments into memories, to turn your trust into faith, and to turn your beautiful smile into beautiful laughter. Well, it surely did.
I feel so special.
Booking a comfortable stay is crucial for me, so I partnered with Agoda, who I can trust. They're great for domestic trips with over 1 lakh properties to choose from in India and 2.9 million worldwide. And I chose Fairmont. It was time to check out my suite. So are you ready? This is the living room. This is the bedroom with a lavish attached bathroom. And look at this beautiful tub with a view. And the best part, the terrace. After a grand welcome at the hotel, we thought of heading to Hawa Mahal, the beautiful palace that I've never visited before. And here's Jaipur for you. The city welcomed me with its warmth, with its characteristic beauty, the rickshaws, the interesting architecture, and mostly the people.
So right now we are at Hawa Mahal. It was, I think, around 20 minutes from our hotel. The streets are really busy. There's a lot of shopping on the streets. The cafes are really busy. Sometimes you also have to pay around 2,000 to 1,000 rupees to get a proper shoot done. Like if you're shooting with your phones, it's all right. But if you're going to use professional cameras, they're going to ask you for some money. But I think it's totally worth it. We came up here and I think this is such a nice place to chill out and to have a great experience of the Hawa Mahal and the whole. We actually wanted to get inside the Mahal also, but I think it's shut right now at this time. But view is incredible. I love it. I've seen it in pictures and now I'm seeing it for real.
The beauty of the Hawa Mahal was undeniably breathtaking. It's a fusion of Islamic, Mughal and Rajput architectural styles and designed in red and pink sandstone. Did you know that this is the tallest building in the world without a foundation? It was built in 1799 by Maharaja Savai Pratap Singh and allowed royal ladies to observe processions on the street who observed the parda system at that time. Now, to observe it, but from a distance, we took a secret route. Not so secret actually. Right opposite the Hawa Mahal is a cafe called Tattoo Cafe that gives you, in my opinion, the best view to the Hawa Mahal. And when I say best view, it also means best photos. The cafe is pretty all right with their food and amazing with the view. I think it's quite popular here because literally everybody took pictures here. I was actually quite surprised to see the Hawa Mahal much, much more beautiful when it was lit up. Now, this is a recent addition to promote night tourism in the city. After gazing at the Hawa Mahal, we took a stroll to Johri Bazaar. Johri Bazaar is one of Jaipur's oldest and most famous bazaar. It's famous for literally everything, starting from Jaipuri jewelry to saris, garments, and local artifacts. They say it's great to bargain here for the right rates. And then I ate some yummy chaat just before dinner. I'm not really a chaat person, but this was yummy. We stopped again at a very popular restaurant at Johri Bazaar called LMB to try some ghevar. So currently we are at this place called LMB. Full form of this place is Lakshmi Mishtan Bhandar. It's right next to the Johri Bazaar and it's full. I mean, it's definitely a very famous place because a lot of people also suggested that I should come here. So there is a sweet section, there's also the savory restaurant, and the paneer ghevar is a specialty here. Although it's very sweet, I've ordered it and I cannot wait to eat it. We also ordered for some kachori, kanda, kachori, kya bol dusko? Dal kachori, pyaz kachori, sorry, my Maharashtrian just came out. So there is pyaz kachori, paneer ghevar, and I think we also ordered for some dhokla. It was very random. But the thali here is very, very special. But we do not want to eat the thali. We had a heavy lunch, so we did not want to overdo it. But we cannot wait for the food.
Okay. Can I taste it, please? Yummy. It looks really good. Mmm. It's actually good.
Wow!
I love fried stuff. I just love everything fried.
Okay.
Now we're gonna taste this. It looks like a honeycomb. If you have a trypophobia, then you might not like this. It's a sweet and it's full of ghee.
And paneer.
Yeah, I mean, where do they put the paneer? It's nice, it's very sweet. I can't eat more than this one.
Good morning from day 2. We woke up at 4 a.m. and headed out. The ideal idea was to catch the sunrise from a fort, but then they all open entries after 10. So we visited some spots along the way to catch the view. Now this was on our way to and from Nahargarh Fort. Thank you. And then I explored the road with a very different perspective. The best part about my traveling is not sticking to my plan at all, actually. I end up doing things much differently than planned, especially when you cannot make it to some spots, you know. What do then? You enjoy what you have. Now, this is me literally locked outside Jaigarh Fort because I was there too early. But it's okay.
Ajab.
At least the monkeys and me, we had some fun. We had some fun conversations, and there were also some cows. After a long morning, we got really hungry, so we left for breakfast to this cafe called The Stag, right in front of Amer Palace.
So after an amazing early morning, we are here at this place called The Stag. It's a cafe right opposite the Amer Palace, which is a beautiful view from the cafe. And right up there, you see the Jaigarh Fort that we were longboarding at. And I had a quick change because I was feeling so hot in that outfit. But I think I love this view. I love the vibe of this place. It's called The Stag. The Amer Palace is a little crowded, so we are going to take a jeep later on after our breakfast and go all the way up. And then wait there for a while, take some pictures, take some videos, and then come back again. So our breakfast is here. I ordered for a masala cheese omelette and a cold coffee. It's really hot outside and we're here in the month of August. So we came in and it's nice and pleasant inside. The food I'm gonna review. It's very cheesy. The cold coffee is really nice. I think you can come here during sunset. It will be amazing with the sun setting and you'll be nice and pleasant, especially if you come here during the winters. Not gonna like it. It's good. It's really good. Now we also have some sandwiches and some aloo parathas. I'm excited for the parathas. Not so much for the sandwiches because I didn't order them. Meera is giving me looks. And I usually like, I've had parathas made at home or something. They've never been as good as this. I'm gonna dip some in the pickle and wow. I love it.
On our way to Amer Palace, we also covered two more important spots. Now, this one being a community requiring water source, this is where the locals would meet to chit-chat, collect water to wash clothes and bathe. Almost like a modern-day community hall. Like their place to hang and chill. Hey, wanna hang? How about 5:30 at the Pannaminaka Kund?
Right now we are at the foot of the Amer Palace. This is the Pannaminaka Kund, which means a step well. It's a square shaped step well. Like the name suggests, it's a well. So there's water here and it was actually made to store water here in Jaipur. If you look at the architecture, it's so interesting. It's so beautiful. And I've seen a lot of people actually go down the stairs and take pictures, but it's actually not allowed. And I'm a little upset about it, but it's all right. Nevertheless, it's so beautiful and I'm so excited to see that India has such beautiful and such interesting spots, especially in the middle of this whole fort area, and it's just so gorgeous.
From there, we reached the top of Amir Palace. The fort is divided into four main sections that are graced with their own courtyards. Now, this is a perfect example of Rajasthani architecture and is a must visit with the Diwane Aam, Sach Mandir, and the Sheesh Mahal. Now this is the Sheesh Mahal at the palace. People take photos here by standing at an angle to get the right reflection. After spending enough time at the palace, we headed towards the palace shop to have a look at how the block printing technique on cloth is created and then to purchase some. This is the local art created, and I would highly recommend to pick some tie-dye cloth to help build local revenue as well.
This is called bandhani, and it basically is like cloth tied together, and then they open it up and it looks like this.
So
after a well-spent afternoon, it was time for lunch. We did our lunch at Fairmont itself, and it was my favorite Rajasthani thali ever. My most favorite part of life, in fact, is food.
I've been craving for this food.
Now I enjoyed the dal bati, the lal mas, and the different types of roti so much, I literally couldn't move after lunch. Welcome to our final day at Jaipur. Now, the history of Rajasthan particularly is so interesting. The massive forts, the palaces, the kings, the queens, it gives me the most royal feeling ever. What would it be like to live here, to have a property as big as this? Let's find out.
So currently we are in the most famous attraction of Jaipur, that is the City Palace. I'm very excited to be here. We actually took the royal entrance. This is the royal tour. So you kind of pay 2000 rupees per adult, but the whole of the palace is empty just for you. This is actually the palace where the Maharaja and Maharani are residing right now. You see, that is their private property. They converted some part of it into a museum, and the people can come visit them. But that's where they stay right now, and that's so incredible. It's so beautiful, and there's so much of history, and there's so many interesting facts about this place which I'm going to witness and which you're going to hear about. So let's get started with that.
The private part of the palace is called the Chandra Mahal. This consists of different parts of the Mahal allowed for the public to visit. Now, when you buy a ticket for this one, you also get a guide to accompany you. Our first stop is the Shobha Nivas. The Maharaja sits here on this spot especially. Look how gorgeous. And this is the stunning view from the palace.
Hi, so right now we are in this beautiful blue room. This was specially made for the celebration of Janmashtami. Now, because Janmashtami is about Lord Krishna, and Lord Krishna loves blue,
this room is painted blue, and here on top you can see there are some hooks. So they basically would have jhulas, and they would keep the statue of Lord Krishna in the jhulas and swing it. How cute is that? You see this room in a lot of photos on Instagram and Pinterest, and I can understand the hype of this place. It's so gorgeous. I would love to just sit here in the evening and have some chai. So currently we are here in the Sheesh Mahal. This used to be the Maharaja's bedroom, and it's covered, like even on the ceiling, with Belgian glass. So it's like pieces of glass, and for the demonstration of what the Belgian glass does, they have two candles here. They light it up and then you can see the whole ceiling have tiny little stars, and they also say that that's how they kept the bedroom warm and cold. I think that is so interesting. So we are at the top of the Chandra Mahal, that is the private Mahal of the Maharaja and Maharani right now. This is the Mukut Mandir, and that means we are at the top of the Mahal. And we see a flag right above us. So this is the private flag of the Mahal. And when the Maharaja is in the Mahal, they also have a tinier flag right on top of it. That's like quarter the size of the flag, to say that the Maharaja is residing in the palace currently. And this palace is made in the middle of Jaipur. So there what you see is the Nahargarh port. So this is our last day here, and we're ending it with some beautiful Rajasthani folk music and dance. And we have something really special arranged for us. We have some dancers and we have some musicians. And this is usually my favorite part about Rajasthan, their folk music, their culture. It's so beautiful, it's so different. And I think I have some questions for them, so let's go.
नमस्कार,
आपका नाम क्या है?
चुट्टन.
क्या?
चुट्टन.
चुट्टन. अच्छा, और ये आप हारमोनियम बजा रहे हैं?
मैं.
और आप कितने साल से बजा रहे हैं?
मैं 20 साल से बजा रहा
हूँ. 20 साल? 20 years. तो आपने मतलब अभी आपको अगर तकलीफ नहीं तो आप कितने साल के हैं? 40. So since you was 20. अच्छा, तो मतलब आप बचपन से नहीं बजा रहे हो, आप 20 साल से बजा रहे हो?
Yes.
तो मतलब 20 साल
की लाइन में 20 साल से बज रहा हूं मैं. वैसे बजा बचपन से बज रहा.
अच्छा, बचपन से बज रहा.
होटल लाइन में 20 साल से
रहा. अच्छा अच्छा,
होटल में एंट्री नहीं है 20 साल से
का. अच्छा अच्छा,
लाइन में 20 साल.
अच्छा, और ये हारमोनियम?
यस मैम,
हारमोनियम. अच्छा, आज आप कौन सा गाना बजाने वाले हो?
केसरिया बादाम पधारो भारत देश.
आई लव दैट सॉन्ग सो मच. इट्स वन ऑफ माय फेवरेट सॉन्ग्स. आई थिंक इट हैज सो मच फील एंड सो मच सोल इन इट. एंड दिस इज द ब्यूटीफुल डांसर. आपका नाम क्या है? माधवी. माधवी इज रियली ब्यूटीफुल. आप बहुत सुंदर हो, और आप मैंने आपका थोड़ा डांस देख लिया ऑलरेडी, और आप बहुत अच्छा डांस करते हो. एंड शी इज सो ग्रेसफुल, यू आर गोना सी दैट आफ्टर अ व्हाइल. एंड आपका नाम?
अमर.
अमर, सो दैट इज अमर, एंड ही इज प्लेइंग द, आप क्या बजा रहे हो?
ढोल.
ढोल. आप कितने साल से बजा रहे हो?
बचपन से
मतलब
बचपन से 5 साल का
5 साल का अच्छा तो 5 सिंस ही वाज 5 इयर्स ओल्ड ही प्लेइंग द ढोल एंड आज कितना डिफिकल्ट है ढोल सीखना इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट एंड एक्चुअली एवरी म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट ठीक है तो मैं बहुत एक्साइटेड हूँ मुझे बहुत मज़ा आ रहा है ये मेरा फेवरेट पार्ट है यूजुअली ऑफ राजस्थानी डांस और मैं आपको डांस करने में ज्वाइन करूँगी ठीक है ऑल राइट लेट्स गो
And this, my friends, is my indigenous journey to Jaipur through my eyes for you with Agoda. It's what I could capture in 3 days and I felt pretty content with what I saw, with what I experienced and what I ate. It's one place I can keep coming to and still be surprised every single time. Until next time, Ram Ram Sahib.